Yan, isang pagpalang oras po, no, mga kapatid.
Ito po ang inyong abang lingkod, Brother Romel A. Palma, ng katotohanan natin pag-usapan. At ngayon, mga kapatid, masusubaybayan nyo na at matutunghayan nyo na ang ating pong programa. Ito po ay tungkol sa katotohanan na ating pong pag-uusapan. Sabi nga ng ating Panginoon, ang katotohanan ang magpapalaya sa atin. Juan 8:22. Nawa ay patuloy po tayo sa pagsaliksik, sa pag-share, sa pagbabahagi po ng ating maliit na ministry or na YouTube channel na ito. Kapagpalang oras po at nawa po pala po kayong lahat ng ating Panginoon.
One of the verses in the Old Testament, we can see the word Jehovah is Exodus chapter 6, verse 3. We cannot read the word Jehovah in other versions. Instead, we can read the English word Lord. This is what we can read in Exodus chapter 6, verse 3 of the Hebrew Bible. Va'era el Abraham, el Yitzhak, ve'el Yaakov, ve'el Shaddai, Oshimi Adonai, lunada'ati lahim. For those who favor that the name of God is Jehovah, they will probably say that Lord cannot be used as a substitute for tetragrammaton because even Abraham was addressed as Lord in the Bible. Well, you are right that Abraham was called Lord. However, they use the Hebrew word Adonai and not Adonai, which is used as substitute for tetragrammaton. We will discuss these three Hebrew words, Adonai, Adon, and Adonai. First, if we say Adonai, this is a masculine noun used exclusively for God. Second, if we say Adon, it is a masculine noun meaning Lord or Master, but the most frequent usage is a human master. But it is also used for divinity. For example, it is used for God, which we can read in Exodus chapter 34, verse 23, Joshua chapter 3, verse 13, and Isaiah chapter 1, verse 24. Third, the Hebrew word Adonai describes human masters and lords, but never God. For instance, we can read in Genesis chapter 23, verse 6, where Lord was used for Abraham. But in Hebrew, we can read the Hebrew word Adonai. In the Hebrew Bible, there is an interlinear where we see the tetragrammaton or Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, and the counterpart of this is the Hebrew word Adonai. According to Jewish tradition, there is a restriction in reading Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. In their tradition, the Jews are very strict when it comes to the name of God. For them, tetragrammaton or Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh is very sacred. However, they often use substitutes when referring to the name of God. For example, they use Hashim or Shim Hameforas. Most scholars agree that the Masoretes avoid pronouncing the divine name. This is what we can read in the book of a biblical scholar, Andreas Scholl, entitled An Introduction to Biblical Aramaic on page 17. The Masoretes, however, avoided pronouncing the divine name and used the vowels of the word Adonai. In Jewish tradition, both the Kiri and the Ketiv are considered highly significant. When reading the Torah scrolls in the synagogue, Jewish law stipulates that Kiri is to be read and not the Ketiv. It means that when they read the Torah scrolls and go over Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, they read it as Adonai. Jehovah is incorrect. It is a mixture of Kiri, Adonai, and Ketiv, Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. In the translation of the New World Translation used by our friends, the Jehovah's Witnesses, And even in their New Testament passage that we can read in Luke chapter 4, verse 18, the word Jehovah is used instead of Lord. In their translation, it is written as Jehovah's Spirit. But if we look at the 4th century manuscript, Codex Sinaiticus, the Greek words pneuma kurio or Spirit of the Lord are clearly written in the nomina sacra. Kurio is the genitive case of kurios. There are many references that say Jehovah is wrong and cannot be used as the name of God. For example, the Jewish Encyclopedia says it is a mispronunciation for Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. The big question is, why do others insist that Jehovah is correct and that it is supported by ancient manuscripts? Let us answer their arguments used by those who believe that Jehovah as the name of God is correct. First, they say Jehovah can be found in the Leningrad Codex. You can see on the screen the manuscript and the word referred to. Well, there is no O sound in the Leningrad Codex. There are only two vowel signs, Shiva under Yud and Kamitz under Vav, as the simple pronunciation would be Yewa. But it's not that simple. The Masoretes had no intention to pronounce the consonants. There is no Hebrew textbook written by reliable Old Testament scholars that the intention of the Masoretes in adding vowels to the tetragrammaton is for its pronunciation. Second, they say Jehovah can be found in the Aleppo Codex. You can see on the screen the manuscript and the word referred to. This allegedly proves that Jehovah is correct since there is hulim or the O sound on top of Vav. What can we say about this? In this case, it looks like two dots over second and third letters. But they may not be hulim since they are lower than the regular hulim points. Notice also that there is a third dot farther up, confirming that these are not hulim. Here's the question. What is the purpose of vowels in tetragrammaton? In the book of biblical scholar David Mitchell, entitled The Song of Ascents, on page 232, he said, the vowels supplied by the Masoretes were not the true vowels of the name at all. The Masoretes substituted the vowels of Adonai to show that Adonai should be read instead of pronouncing the true name. Third, they also insist that Jehovah can be read in Psalm chapter 83, verse 19. Here is the screenshot of Psalm chapter 83, verse 19 from my Hebrew Bible. In the tetragrammaton, we can see the vowel Shiva under Yud, vowel Kamitz under Vav, and the other one that looks like a comma or an inverted L. The question is, does this mean that Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh can be read as Jehovah? The answer is no. What you can see is one of the accent marks called monach. The monach is a conjunctive accent, part of the vocalization and cantillation system to aid in the recitation and singing of the text. It is a symbol to pronounce the synonym Elohim, although the written word is Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh. Brothers and sisters, I hope You have learned a lot from this discussion. Thank you for watching and listening. And once again, we would like to thank Dr. Harold Attridge of Yale University and Dr. Lauren Shipman of New York University for giving time for this very important discussion. May the Lord continue to watch over us during this pandemic. Amen.